Welcome back, everyone, to Donkey Kong Country. Not Donkey Country, but DKC64. Let's go. Fight the boss. Go to the next world. So we can go to the next world. That fat pig. Oh, spooky. This is a cool back thing. You didn't know who you were gonna, or what you were gonna fight. If it was the first time. First fight's still... That's still cool, but... easy, but still a little bit challenging. But yes, still a bit suspenseful too. Ooh. I got it. About two or three more times. Does do rematch fights like DK2 does. I mean, not DK2, DK Country 1. There's a lot of boss refights in that. Or rematches. This is still pretty good. Every boss game has its own boss theme. Bossy for your original stage in the game. Pretty much just a remix for him, the stage theme. Ah. Oh. Go! Last hit's kinda hard to get. Oh, never mind. But I have one more hit left. Must be thinking of the rematch with them. Or her. Is it he or her? I don't know. Yeah, open the cage. So the crocodile can just do his little dance. And they go to the next world. And yeah, it's pretty much done. I'm not gonna come back here until I have all the Kongs. Which will be until I reach third level in the world. Because I get chunky in that one. The second world, which one I'm going to next, will get tiny and lanky. Let's go. Where am I? This music is so good. So nice and relaxing. Do a little dance. I'll grab a soda while he's doing this. He's doing that cage to make that kind of moaning sound. I don't want to know. I got There's a lot of secret stuff in the world in this place. Of the big overworld games, platformers like Mario 64, Banjo-Kazooie, even maybe Ocarina of Time, if you count that one. I think the overworld one, this one's better. This and Banjo are the best overworld. Let's see, Banjo-Kazooie one. That one had more secrets to find. I mean, like, for the hub area. The main hub area. So many secret things in this hub area. Ooh, I'm not doing that yet, as I'm gonna need Tiny to reach the barrel that comes out right here. Can't get to that barrel. Get to that barrel without the flying upgrade at the third level, I think it was. Pretty sure it was the third world. We either get the flying ability. Oh yeah, Darmadillo.
Too quick for me, but I'll get him next time.
Mm-hmm. I don't like failure. You know what happens to failures. I've waited too long. What the fuck is my plan this time?
Okay. Angry Aztec. I think I'm gonna turn my mic's volume up so I can hear the music better. There we go. Oh, one thing. Meant to jump, not do that. Meant to jump, not attack. Oh, do this. Okay, I'm supposed to, I'm supposed to use the invincibility barrel. I don't have to upgrade for it yet to become invincible, to walk over there without getting hurt, but I don't have time for that. I'm just gonna take the pain. Oh! Okay, this is kinda hard to walk up. I think I'm gonna shoot him. Yeah! Love doing that. Shooting him. I'm gonna die. Probably. Mom, come on, camera, work with me. Stupid camera. Nope, let me do that. I wish they released, like, a controller for the Wii U or Wii. It's more like similar looking design to the N64 controller. So I can hit the C buttons, you know, without having to use a stick to hit the C buttons. Remember? It was a C button. I'm gonna die again. Bye, everyone. Am I sinking? I am now. Oh! I'm gonna go do that. I'm not gonna walk into that again. No, don't miss that again. and I can get further. Yeah, I'd rather be able to get all the bananas here in one go. So I think I'm just gonna get the amount I need, go to the next world, and beat the boss here as well, because you do that too, the next world. Get Tiny and Linky, go to world 3, just gotta save them and stuff. Go to world 3, so I can get just enough. Ah, why does that always happen? So let's go save Chunky and do everything I can do at the factory level, and then come back to the past two ones. Candy looks a lot better than she did in the first game. She was like the only game she was in before this. Yeah. One appearance she had in Country Series was the first game as the save spots. She didn't do her little laugh. She had this weird laugh she normally does when you talk to her the first time. Oh. Wait. Yeah, I did the same for Diddy. Wait, did it? Did it give me two lives? Oh, it did. I think the maximum you could get was either three or four. Yep, I get upgrade. Oh, not upgrade, I guess you might. Musical. Like the stance they all make when they're in her little hut. They all like her. Oh. Though it's a bit funny if you try to bring Tiny in there. Tiny has real disdain for her. Tiny one you won't even bother to look at. See, this is Diddy or no, not Diddy. That's Shep, Llama. Llama. Shut up, Llama Obama. I don't know if the fifth banana speech level is supposed to be the blueprints or not. Technically, you can turn those in at any level in the game. Then I go back to using Diddy again. Don't really use Diddy. I mean, not Diddy. Don't really use DK Lemons at all, really. Other than maybe like a few Golden Bananas, he's not really required all that much. Oh wait, what's that? Ooh, a balloon. Why would I need to go over the life system? Well, I guess they was the DK 64, well, wrong game. And with the Banjo-Kazooie approach to the lives, where it was more of a hassle, we ran out of lives. But they climb all the way back up Grunty's mountain. Well, then getting the live system in Banjo is kind of pointless. At least in the original one. Because they might as well not even give you lives in Banjo-Kazooie 1. Because when you die, and you have not collected all the notes in the level, you have to You have to go and re-get every note you already got again. Which makes you redo everything you just did. What's the point of a life system? Even if you do die, so you gotta do everything over again. I think I already have enough bananas for the boss. I think it was either 150 or 120 or 150 bananas for this world for the boss. Yeah, guys. Rocket jet pack now. Or wear my pack. Does he have enough coins, though? Yes, he does. Now, the Candy Kong and Funky Kong shops still pop up in the worlds after we get all five Kongs. That might make you wonder why they keep showing up after that. As, they're only there for each world for you can get the Kongs, their weapons, and their music. Well, instead of giving you guns or music because you already have all of them. And, but once you reach for world 4, you already have all the guns and music for everyone. At that point, it either does two things. Either the gun shop will give you more ammo, or at one particular point, it will give you, homing ammo at a certain point. Or... Oh, yeah, that's pretty much it. Funky Kong will give you the option to pay coins to increase the ammo you can hold. I don't remember if it was universal for all the Kongs, so... I don't know if I have to buy the ammo upgrade for every Kong. Ah, that wouldn't make sense, because the ammo is kind of universal for all the Kongs, isn't it? Yeah, they all share the same ammo. So, Funky does that. He gives you ammo upgrades, and I think the very last Funky Kong shop, or the one before it, gives you homing ammo. No. It was that, and he also gives you a scope functions. So you can get a sniper barrel to your guns where you can zoom in and fire from long range. So Candy Kong will either increase the amount of music you can use. Say tiny now. Oh yeah, I was saying. Can you upgrade now on ZK over there? Yeah, he'll just refill my ammo. Yeah. As I say, Funky Kong will give you more ammo upgrades. You can upgrade your guns, you can more ammo. Maybe new in the world. And there's two upgrades you get late game that, one that makes it where your bullets home, and then one that makes it where you can zoom in and out. You can turn into a sniper. Oh, Candy Kong shall increase the amount of health you can hold, which gives you a whole nother warm on, and increase the amount of music you can have. Oh. Because I gotta walk all the way back. Oh, never mind. Let's do this. I get Tiny first because I think I have to have her though. Even save Monkey. Nope. I'll check pull out my gun. Not that. It's really hard. Oh. That's right. The guy's up there. I forgot about that. By the time we get to the jetpack, the blueprint will despawn, so. I'll just go in here. Frozen? Yeah. Ow. Why don't we decide watermelon for a life system? I hate this part. That's probably easier to do than was in the ROM version though. He backflips high. I think I need timing though to get Linky. Camera could just work with me. No! You did the wrong thing. You're supposed to backflip up, not long jump. I wasn't even moving. Not sure why you did the. A long jump. Oh, not really a long jump. I wish there was a Wii U or Wii can. Nope! I didn't even hit up. Hit left. Yeah. Trying to, go in the direction to activate the gun this way. It's kind of hard because any slight angle of going up. No! Why do you jump? I mean, do that. What's even moving or running? Keeps doing a long jump instead. Trap hold the gun, not do that. Pretty much have the point down where I tried to go left. Just any slight direction of going. Hey, did I hit it? Well, that could. Oh, wait. I got it. No! Man. Okay, this is just as annoying as it was when I did it on the ROM version. Hey! Oh, yeah. Come on. Nope. Stop. Slightly. It's a little too sensitive. Missed. Still missed. Oh, wait, no. I got the time. No! No! Stop doing the wrong move! Why is it he was not grabbing on the ledge, too? Come on. Ah. Get there! Come on, got it. I'm gonna do Banjo Kazooie when this is over. No! Not that! What? Turn the camera around. Why? You keep doing that move. I'm not moving. Well, technically I am moving because the thing's pulling back, but I'm not pushing the button to move. The camera angle makes it almost impossible to do it without falling. I'm trying to run down the path. I'm running out of ammo by the time. Why get the stupid switch? Oh, you got it. Just turn the camera around. God! Finally! Way more effort than it should have to do. How much time do I got? Might have to. I could probably. Nope, I'm out of here. Next time we'll save Tiny Kong next episode.